Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about questions that refer to the phrase at least once. So I'm going to do, I think, four different examples. They're all pretty varied, but they all do ask something in there at least once or at least one. And there's a certain way to do that, but I wanted to show you a slightly different example first, and then we'll go through the other ones. It may take a couple of videos to get through these. So the first one is, if you were to flip a coin four times, what is the probability that the coin would come up heads at least once? So I want you to think about, what does that mean, at least once? It means that maybe one head would come up, maybe two, maybe three, or maybe four. Any of those would be at least once, so it's one or greater. So the only time we wouldn't get what we were wanted here would be if we had the unlucky, if we were trying to get heads, occasion to get tails four times. That would not be any heads. Everything else would be working. So I mentioned this before, and it's worth repeating. If there are two outcomes for this, for each event, then the total possible number of outcomes for all the events is 2 to the nth power, where n is the number of iterations for the event. So for four tosses of a coin, it's 2 to the fourth power. It could be heads or tail. That's where we get 2 for our sample space there, or for our event, for one, our sample space for one event is 2. And then we have 4 times we're doing that. So 2 to the fourth power is 16 outcomes in that entire sample space for 4 tosses. If you need to have at least one heads, and the only time you would not meet that criteria was when you flip 4 tails, which we mentioned up here, which could only happen once. So there's one time out of 16 when you wouldn't get what you wanted here. So for heads being greater than or equal to 1, which is heads at least 1, 15 out of 16 times you would get that. And there'd be only 1 out of 16 times when you'd get all tails. If you were asked how many times would the heads come up exactly twice, this would require more effort. You would have to actually look at all the outcomes and count up all the times when there were 2 occurrences of heads. But at least once, because of that phrase, it gives us an easier out, because all we have to do is remember that there's only one time that we would have not at least one, and that would be if we had 0. So that's why at least one's a little special. Okay, some totally different example. Let's say that you were going to survey students based on the last 4 digits of their student ID numbers. So numbers can be repeated in the ID number. That means it has with replacement, so they could be 9999. It's okay. Find the probability that for one student selected, the 4 digits contain at least 1 7. See how we get the at least 1 in there? We want to make sure there's at least 1 7. Every time we select a number, we have 10 digits to choose from, 0 through 9. So that gives us 10 different possibilities for each one. So the chance of choosing a 7 when we draw a number is 1/10. But if we used 1/10 to do this, at 1/10 we would be saying, what's the probability that we drew something that had 4 sevens in it? That if we multiplied 1/10 times each other. So we don't want to use 1/10. At least 1, we need to figure out what the probability of not having a 7 is. And then we subtract that value from 1. Because at least 1 means that there is only one instance that we would not meet our goal, and that is if we had 0 sevens. So the probability of having at least 1 7, you have 1 minus, and then the probability of having no sevens, because having no sevens is the only bad thing for us. So the probability of no sevens is 9 out of 10. If you had 10 numbers in a hat and you drew, then you have 9 chances of not getting a 7, right? And if you did that 4 times with replacement, so you're putting the number back in every time, so you have 9/10 times 9/10 times 9/10 times 9/10, and that equals 0.656. And then we would take that number, because this represents how often we would have no 7s, and we subtract that from the total 1. And that gives us 0.344, which means the probability that we would pick somebody's number randomly and we'd see at least 1 7 in there is about 34.4% of the time we would see that. So notice what we did. We wanted to know if at least 1, so we figured out, well, what happens when there's none, and then we subtracted that from 1. Okay, at least one more example. Maybe you have to come back and do the next one again. So here's this one. A certain company, whoops, I need to go down a little bit so we can see it all. A certain company that manufactures discount tents has shown that 72% of them will not leak. What is the probability that among three randomly selected tents, at least one of them will not leak? So how would this affect your choice when you and two friends are buying a tent for an extended camping trip? So you're going to buy three tents. You're going to buy one and your two friends are going to buy one. So you're going to buy three tents. And what we want to know is, what is the probability that of those three tents, at least one of them will not leak? Because we want to know, well, if we have a downpour, is there at least one tent that we could get into and stay dry? Okay, so if A is the event that the tent does not leak, and we are interested in at least one, so we need to look at the probability of the complement of A, which is the event that the tent does leak. If the tent does not leak 72% of the time, which they told us, that means that the tents do leak 28% of the time, or 0.28. So that's the probability that we're going to work with. So the probability that at least one of the three tents will not leak is 1 minus the probability that all tents do leak. Because there's going to be one case where they all leak, and then every other case is going to have at least one that doesn't. So we're going to get three tents. That's where the third power comes to. We have 0.28 to the third power, and we subtract that value from 1 and find out that our tents, if we bought 3, we'd have a 0.978% chance, or not percent, 0.978 probability that we would have at least one tent that wouldn't leak. Now, not everybody who goes on a trip, everybody's going to have their own tent. So if you were just going to buy one tent, you'd definitely have a 28% chance that you'd have a leaky tent. It might not be worth it. But if everybody did want to carry their own tent and there was room for you guys to squeeze in, it might be nice to have that. Okay, I'm going to come back and do a couple more examples with at least one. Have a fantastic day.